Hi, this video is for anyone who's new both to Call of Duty and Advanced Warfare on the 360 or any other platform as well. And it's specifically for people who want to get better at team deathmatch on Advanced Warfare Online. And if you're tired of getting your butt kicked but aren't sure where to start, this could be the video for you. UAV ready. First thing I've got to say is I'm no expert at Call of Duty Advanced Warfare Team Deathmatch Online. I only got my Xbox 360 at Christmas 2015 after we gave my son an Xbox One, and I've only been playing online for about 2 months. But I feel that because I'm so far behind the learning curve for first-person shooters, I've had to do an awful lot of research into how to get better in a methodical way, rather than just randomly over time. I mean, the last console I had was a PS2 playing Medal of Honor Frontline, storming the beaches of Normandy 13 years ago. So when I first went gold, I had my behind handed to me by 12-year-olds every time I went online to play Team Deathmatch. I'm not saying that still doesn't happen. In fact, last night when I was playing, it did very regularly. You know, I can still have matches when I get less than 10 kills and I'm killed twice that amount. But with the right map, the right teammates, and the right opposition, I can get 20 plus kills and be the highest scorer on the winning team. And how I've got here is what I wanted to share with every other noob out there who wants to avoid being humiliated, and blown off the map in the public matches. None of the techniques in the video are my ideas. I've borrowed them off some amazing YouTubers and players, and I'll credit them where I can with the likes of Exclusive Ace and Drifter, Keith and Mate from Work, but the biggest help has been from my son Oliver, who is an amazing player, and his advice has helped an old 43-year-old recapture some of his gaming youth. Anyway, that's enough of the waffle. In this video, I'm assuming you can do the basics, run around the map, aim, do some exo moves, etc. And remember, all of this really relates to Team Deathmatch, not the other game modes, where tactics can be quite different and where you really do need to think about things a little bit more. In Team Deathmatch, you know, we do have to think about our teammates and where they are, but basically we've simply got to kill more people than we get killed ourselves, and that will contribute to our team winning or losing. And so what we're going to be covering are your loadout, including your guns, wildcards, perks, score streaks. We're going to be looking at a four-step practice and warm-up routine that is the key to improving your accuracy, speed, exo ability, map awareness and tactics, and to get a bit of COD. And that will include the firing range, an exo and accuracy drill on Detroit against bots, a speed exo and accuracy drill on comeback with bots again, and there's also going to be a practice team deathmatch against bots on a map we're not familiar with. We're going to look at a good system and environment setup to help you succeed, how to move safely around the map, a quick look at the exo moves that maybe you're not doing. I'm going to do a little bit on how to read the minimap, some common starting rushes, some common mistakes that people make, the importance of changing tactics when appropriate, how to deal with jumpers, and what you'll probably use your grenades for, playing different game modes and knowing when to stop, researching tactics and tips and hints. We're going to have a quick look at the combat readiness program, and there'll be a conclusion, and then at the end there'll be an example game. Now, if you're watching on YouTube, you should see most of these subjects on the screen now, little kind of menu items, so you can click through to the section you want to look at. So in a second or two, they'll disappear. But if you want to come back here just to see, you know, a different section, just click on the menu button that you'll see probably in the top left-hand corner of the screen. Unfortunately, on some mobile devices, you won't see these links, so you'll either have to watch all the way through or jump back and forth using the navigation bar. Anyway, let's get started. Okay, so in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare Team Deathmatch, something that can make a massive, well, that does make a massive difference, I think, is your class, your loadouts, if you like. So let's take a look at what I run with. And I run with, at the moment, two main guns. I run with the BAL 27 and the ASM1. They're just the base variants, and then I have various bits attached to them. I would say that the BAL is probably the one to start off with, because it's pretty accurate, it's easy to handle, it's better at medium to longer ranges, and it just seems like a better starter gun when you first get into the game. And the ASM, being a submachine gun and not an assault rifle like the BAL, is much, much better at close to medium range, but anything longer than that can be tricky, and it can be a bit of a handful. So I would say start off with a bal and sort of soup it up with the different attachments. So let's look at my bal setup first. So if we go into the bal, obviously we've got a bal 27, and then I use the stock. Now the stock is great for improving your mobility while aiming down sight. So basically you can strafe left and right and move faster with the stock on. And then I use two front grips. I use the foregrip and the quick draw grip. The quick draw grip is self-explanatory, to whip it out faster to try and win gunfights. And the foregrip is there to reduce recoil, so especially at longer ranges. And I mean, with the BAL 27, at very long ranges, sniper rifle ranges, I think as long as you can pick out your enemy and they're not moving, you can hit them with a BAL with these things. You'll notice I don't run with a secondary gun at all, because I think that just slows you down. And then if we look at my perks, I run low profile, so they can't see you on the minimap. Incredibly important that if they can't see you coming, you're going to stay alive much longer. Lightweight, so I can run around fast. Again, in Advanced Warfare, things move so fast, you've got to always think that someone's either chasing you or there's a sniper trying to get bead on you, so you want to be moving quickly around the map. Blind eye, I think, is another really important one. And with blind eye, what that means is you're invisible to things like sentry guns, drones, like paladins. They just can't see. Well, if it's manually controlled, they can see you, but if it's an automatic one, they can't see you. And especially automatic sentry guns, it's so good just to be able to run up to them, punch them, and get rid of them. And then my final perk three, is the blast suppressor. And what this does is when you're boosting around the map, those boosts don't appear on the mini-map. So that's really, really good. Exo ability, exo overclock I do. And what that does is that speeds you up for a short amount of time. And I keep one launcher, which is the Semtex, which I use in specific situations. You might want to go with the normal grenade. I like the Semtex because it sticks to things. And it's always a great pleasure in team deathmatch to stick a Semtex onto somebody and then see them run around, hopefully into their teammates, and blow them up too. I only go with one score streak at the moment. That's the UAV. And if we look at the mods I put on it, go with support. Always go with support as soon as you can, because support means that as you die, the points that you're making up stay being added up. So it may be that, you know, when you're first starting off, you may only get one UAV per match. But at least you'll get one. You kind of feel like you're contributing to your team, and having a UAV up in the air definitely helps. And then I run with extra time, so it's up there for longer. Threat detection is a really good one to add on to that, because you can see enemies through walls and stuff, but it's another 300, so it becomes a very expensive score streak. But do remember that with the UAV, if they're running lightweight, you won't be able to see them. So don't rely on it completely. Now you may be saying, well, wait a minute, to start off with, you know, how can I can't choose all these things, it won't let me. And an example of this, if we go to say my AK, which I haven't used for a while, as you can see, if I try and go into the attachments, I can't use the stock, I can't use the quick draw grip or the foregrip. As you highlight the box, you'll see over on the left hand side, it tells you what you've got to do. So if I want to get the foregrip for the AK, I need to get 10 kills while aiming down the sights. So all you do is, when you're in a match, whether it be a team death match or domination or something else, just mucking around, just concentrate on aiming down the sights and getting 10 kills. Quick draw grip, get 10 headshot kills. So again, practice doing that, you know, in a real game though. And then to get the stock, it's quite tricky, the stock, 20 hip fire kills, so you've got to shoot people. But that's how you basically ramp up your attachments. Now, other things like the perks that you can get at different times all depends on the level you are. So as you're playing Advanced Warfare and you work your way through the game, you get more points and you change rank, don't you? You'll have seen that happening already until you get to 50. And as you go up through the levels, different things become available to you. So when you go in and you'll look at the perks, let's go into this one and have a look. It's a bit of an odd one, this one, because I'm at level 50 now. I can get hold of anything, because I'm about to sort of throw all those points away and prestige. But that's the BAL. So I would say start off with the BAL, get it souped up with all those attachments, and it's a good kind of all-rounder. And the kind of style you have when you start off, where you're kind of going around a bit slower because you're not that sure about your exo movements, it can be a really good weapon. Then the ASM. Now, the ASM is definitely my favourite weapon now. The enemies that I'm coming up against now in the matches, because with the idea with skill-based matchmaking is in games is as you get better, so do your opponents. The BAL doesn't always cut it, especially in a smaller map, say like Comeback is a really good example of that. Or what else is there? Any of the smaller maps, Solar, you know, the ASM, you know, really rocks it. And then what I put on it, I put the advanced rifling to improve the range and the accuracy. I put the foregrip on, again, to try and control some of that recoil, because this thing can jump around, and a quick draw grip. So when I'm in that situation where I'm face-to-face, I can whip out and blast my enemies. And I go with exactly the same attachments. Low profile, so I don't appear on the minimap. Lightweight, so I can move fast. And when you're running with a submachine gun, you can move very, very fast indeed. Blind eye, so I'm invisible to sentry guns and drones and stuff like that. Blast suppressor. Exo overclock to speed me up to get me into the battle or out of problems. Semtex again, because you'll see a bit where I talk about ways that you can use grenades. And I find that Semtex is the most useful one. Again, it's not available straight away. As you level up, you'll find that becomes available. And then the only score streak I run with is the UAV. But again, I put support on it so that any points I earn towards it, you know, add up even if I die, and I have extra time on it as well. So there we go. So they're my two weapons, the BAL and the ASM. I'd recommend that, you know, as you become kind of a better gunfighter, you may well decide to forego some of these perks or attachments because you might want more score streaks. But I would say to start off with, you definitely want to be concentrating on improving your gunplay. Because what we're trying to avoid in all of this is something that's referred to as the paralysis of choice. Because with this kind of setup, with the BAL or the ASM, where you're basically running a machine gun, a submachine gun or an assault rifle, and they're both fully automatic though, with one score streak, you haven't really got any choices about what you're going to do, you know, as you're running around. In most situations, when you see an enemy on the screen, all you're going to do is you're going to start firing at them. If you're very, very close though, you're either going to start firing them or you're going to punch them. Or maybe, you know, you're going to run away. You don't have to worry about whipping out a secondary weapon. You don't have to worry about whether you're trying to build up to a big score streak for a bombing run or a special suit or something like that. You know, it's all just about killing people with your machine gun. And again, as you get faster and more accurate, you may want to experiment with different setups, say a different gun. Like at the moment, a gun that I'm really liking is the... is the IMR. Really enjoy shooting with that, and probably after I've prestiged, I'll probably use the IMR rather than the BAL for a while, just to try and get used to it. And you may want to change your perks as well. So you might want to put on toughness. Now the beauty with toughness is that one stops you flinching quite as much when you get shot, which is very, very good. So when you're a face-to-face gun fight and you're both firing at each other, as soon as you get hit, your gun jumps and one or two of your bullets will probably miss, but with toughness they don't. You might want to put on hardwired so that when there's a system hack that doesn't affect you, which can be very, very useful indeed. But don't muck around too much. I think if you follow this basic setup, you can't go wrong. And again, it doesn't give you too much choices in what you've got to do. You've got to run around the map shooting at people, lobbing the odd grenade, And that's about it. And the other thing I say as well is, as your skill level improves, certain perks or attachments and guns will become less helpful. So your loadout will change. So for example, with me at the moment, just about to prestige for the second time, I found that the BAL has become less useful for me in most of the matches that I come across. I tend to end up switching to the ASM. Whereas when I was starting off, the BAL, that was the gun. I just used the BAL all the time, and it was very, very good at all. But as far as the different classes go, I would say start with the BAL, because that's really good for medium to long range maps. Then build up the ASM as well, and they're your two choices. Use the ASM for close maps and the BAL for longer ones. And as you become more adept at moving fast around the map and understanding where players tend to go, you'll probably find yourself developing a style that will favour one particular type of gun. And again, I'll say again, for me at the moment, it's the ASM, because it's a quick killer up close and gives you the mobility to run around the map real fast. But, you know, the problem with the ASM is you've got little chance of winning long-range gunfights unless you're very, very lucky or very, very accurate. So there we go. That's our quick look at classes. And next up, we're going to look at the four-step practice and warm-up routine. Okay, so if you want to get better at anything, you've got to practice, which means breaking the whole thing down into manageable chunks so you work on individual skills instead of trying to work on everything at once. If you wanted to become a better footballer, you wouldn't improve by throwing yourself into a full competitive game to start off with, would you? You'd practice shooting, passing, dribbling, free kicks, headers, tackling, etc. Then maybe you'd play some small matches with some friends, run some drills, and then, you know, maybe you'd be ready for the big time. But you wouldn't play like a whole season. You'd play like in the reserve first, wouldn't you? And then you'd move up. But this is what we can do with COD. You know, if we break it down and practice different spits first, when we move into the, you know, the public games with everybody else, things will become much, much better. The drills we're going to be working through also act as an excellent warm-up, because just like sport, if you want to do well, you've got to warm up properly. You've got to get your eye in. You've got to get your fingers warmed up. And I think this four-step practice routine is the key to getting better at Call of Duty Advanced Warfare Team Deathmatch. So I would say, if you can do this every time your console gets turned on, no matter how much you want to jump straight into Xbox Live, you will get better and you will enjoy the game more and have more fun. So the first thing we do is we want to work on our basic aiming skills on the firing range, funnily enough. And you get into that by going to create a class, go into your, say, the BAL, because that's what we're going to work with, and then you press the start button. And lo and behold, here we go, we're in the firing range. And what I would say is the two that I enjoy working with is lane 3 and lane 4. It's dead easy. All you've got to do, in fact, let me just turn down the volume on my computer because it's coming back with the sound. All you've got to do is go into lane 3, and here we go, and it's going to start. And what you're practicing here, if I do it slowly to start off with, you're practicing firing, moving, aiming, firing. Now, if the targets are very close together, like these two, you can move across while still aiming down the sights. But if they're far apart, say I wanted to move to the top left-hand corner one, release your aim, move across till you get your crosshairs in the middle, then aim. So the idea is you're kind of doing that, release, move, aim, like that, rather than kind of always aiming down the sights like this. Which, although can be effective, it's not as fast as going shoot and then move and then shoot again. Okay, so that's all you're working on. And the firing range is excellent for that. Let's do a little, say, if we get this moving target here. Ooh, if I can actually get my target on. I managed to miss him at loads of times. There we go. So, for example, from this guy here, we shoot him like so, and then we snap down to take out that guy. And it's all about the practice. And once you've done that one, lane 3 is sort of further away stuff, and lane 4 is a bit more intense. It's kind of all in your face. More like this. And I tend to practice with the BAL, because the BAL is my kind of long-range weapon of choice, whereas the ASM I tend to have a little bit more success with. Again, it's all about just speed and accuracy. Just take the time to do it, and you'll find that before long, your accuracy will improve incredibly. And now we're going to come out of it, and we're going to do some training using bots. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to do the second part of our practice drill, if you like, which is an accuracy and speed drill, courtesy of Exclusive Ace of YouTube fame. But we're going to come out of Xbox Live, and we're going to go into local play for this one. And we're just going to sign in, and we're going to set the game up. Now, this first one is all about speed and accuracy, really. So what we're going to do is we're going to change the map to Detroit, because Detroit, it's got some nice big open areas, and the mode is going to be free for all. And the bots, we're going to have 9. Now, I think if you're running on an Xbox One rather than 360, you can have more bots, can't you? But, you know, if you find this drill becomes a little bit difficult, i.e. you're getting killed all the time and you get much practice, turn the bots down. And then, but you want to turn the bot difficulty down to recruit, because this isn't all about the technicalities of beating bots. It's about shooting targets that are kind of moving a little bit as accurately as you can. And the kind of the idea of this is that we're going to run around and we're just going to practice shooting bots and then switching from target to target out in the open. Doesn't matter how many times we get killed, we're just going to be practicing running around, shooting, moving, evading, shooting, reloading, all this sort of stuff in a quite safe environment. So let's dive in, and I'll try and talk as I'm doing this. I'm not sure how successful this will be, because I tend to have to concentrate quite a lot. And again, the idea isn't to snipe people. I mean, we might do a little bit of sniping just to get some sniping practice in. It's all about practicing our ability to run around. So we're going to use the BAL, because the BAL's better on this sort of map. And here we go. Let's see where it throws us in. Let's have a go. And even when like the UAV comes up, I'm not going to use it, because in this sort of game, the minimap's on all the time. So let's rock and roll. There'll probably be someone up here with me. There normally is. Try and get into the action as soon as we can. Again, it's a good idea to practice your exo moves as we go around. Let's have a look. Right, whoop, target. Right, ooh, they're probably behind me. Let's get over here. Let's reload in a safe place. Oop, didn't see him, did I? Right, okay, let's concentrate. Let's do some long sniping from over here. There we go. Right, that's good. It gets our eye in. Let's get into the, again, it's all about getting into the action as fast as we can. Keep an eye on that mini-map so you know where the enemies are going to be. If there's going to be someone around here. Where's he gone? No, he's gone down there. There we go. Let's reload. Now remember, double tap. Ooh, there's someone coming out those stairs behind me. Ooh, remember, double tap X to do a quick reload. You'll... Ooh, missed him. Ooh, punch. There we go. We got rid of that guy. Ooh, there's more somebody out. Punch. Oop, punch again. Oh, run away, run away. I haven't got any bullets. Right, double tap X, do a quick reload. Get back into the action again. And if you find you're kind of... Oop, you're not getting the kills in. Like, at the moment, I'm kind of missing everywhere. Just slow down a bit. I mean, it doesn't matter how many times you get killed. It's just all about the practice of getting on target. And if you can as well, try and do some... try and do some evasive action, so do a bit of strafing. Woo! Try and do some strafing as you're getting shot. In fact, let's have another go at some long range stuff. I'm not very good at long range. In fact, I've just used the whole clip and missed them completely. Let's get in closer. Woo! Punch. Punching is incredibly important in Modern Warfare, actually. Ooh, here comes somebody. Oh, someone's behind me. Should have moved faster. In fact, that bit of the map there at the top, it can be quite tricky in this, because you're very open to getting attacked by different angles. So often I like to work my way back towards this end of the map. Woo! Again, I should have didn't keep an eye on my double kill. Let's get down here. He's behind there. Shoot from the hip. Oh, somebody else got me. So you kind of get the idea. It's just all about shooting, moving, shooting. Just trying to switch between targets. And being, you know, quite aggressive, because it's all about firing and getting on target. Like so. Ooh. And then when you're in a dangerous situation where you need to sort of reload, get yourself safe, doing double tap reloads, get yourself used to those. Keep an eye on that mini-map. And there's nothing wrong with moving it out around a bit to just get a bit of practice, exo practice in. And what you find some of the guys when they do this, Exclusive Ace does this as well, is they'll increase the health that you can have. If you go in the options to help you with that, and generally just sort of just customize it for how you want to run the drill. And again, if you find yourself losing a lot and dying a lot, just slow down, improve on your accuracy. Oop. And don't jump around so much, because remember, these bots are, they're dummy bots, they're only recruits, so they're pretty crap. They're not going to be jumping all over the place. Tell you what. Ooh. Oh, there's loads of them. Grenade. See, even firing bots can be good fun. Fighting bots can be good fun. Right, we're almost there. We need 3 more kills, and then we'll have completed the exercise, if I can stay alive. Here we go. One more. Where are they? Right up the middle. There we go. So, you know, it doesn't take very long, this routine, but you'll find that as you play it more and more and more, you'll get really good at killing bots, you know, and bots are different to people, but your accuracy will go up incredibly, and especially your accuracy under pressure. So there we go. That's the second part of the warm-up, playing Detroit against bots who are on recruit on a free-for-all, just to get your accuracy up. So now let's look at the drill we're going to do on comeback. Okay, so that was a bit of fun, wasn't it? Running around Detroit. So let's look at the next one we're going to look at. We're going to change the map to comeback. This is a really small, intense map. And not only are we going to go on a more smaller and more intense map, we're going to put the bot difficulty up to regular for this one. If you find you keep getting killed and you're not getting better at this particular drill, knock the bot difficulty back to recruit until you get good at it, and then knock it up to regular, or, you know, move the number of bots down as well. As I say, some of the guys, when they're doing these drills, they'll change some of the options. So you can go into like health and damage and give yourself more health. I tend to just play with whichever one I've got. And actually, there was something I want to mention that I should have mentioned before, is that we're in local play now, but what you'll notice, if you look at my classes, they're identical in local play as they are on my Xbox Live, and that's really important as well. So whatever you're playing with on Xbox Live, with the BAL and the ASM, just make sure in these practice sessions locally that the setup is exactly the same, so that you won't get any surprises when you go into the public matches. So there we go. So we set it to comeback. We're on free for all. We've got bots 9. We've gone up to regular difficulty. Now what you want to look out for on this is, again, with Advanced Warfare, Team Deathmatch, and even though we're playing free-for-all, if you want to contribute to your team winning, you've got to kill more people more times than you get killed. So you want to be at least trying to kill 2 people for every time you get killed. Now, that isn't possible to start off with. You'll find yourself getting killed again and again and again, and it happens to me now. But the trick to getting more than one kill, especially if people are in front of you, is your speed that you can switch between targets, and this map and this routine is really good for that. Because what you should see me doing is aiming down the sights as I'm moving around the map, going to different situations, and as I'm changing between targets, coming out of aiming down the sights, moving across, then aiming again. You'll probably see quite a few hip fires, and you'll probably see quite a lot of exo movements as well. Just getting used to moving around the map as fast as possible. Well, as efficiently as possible, checking corners. You'll see me flicking left and right or not. But anyway, let's get in and let's see. Now, I probably won't be able to talk as much in this particular drill because I've got to concentrate quite a lot. Otherwise, I'll just get thrashed. And again, it's first to 30, which we will get, but it's all about just concentrating. So here we go. So now this is a small map, so we're going to be using the ASM one. There we go, ASM. This can get a bit intense actually sometimes, and it is a lot of fun as well. I love this map because it's so close. But the bots, obviously, because they're pretty dumb, you know, they're pretty much cannon fodder. But what I bet you watch, but they're going to kind of beat me on this one. So I think normally someone's up there. So let's roast him if I can hit him. Wow, that was a bit of a rubbish start, wasn't it? Right, let's go. Less talking. Let me just concentrate on killing. Double tap. Ooh, there's somebody over there. Let's get out of the way. Wait. Get him. Some more people down here. Notice I'm kind of jumping and moving around a lot. Punch. Double tap X. Quick reload. Quick look at the minimap. There's somebody over there. Somebody over there. I'm trying to move around as fast as I can to avoid, and trying to get out of situations. Ooh, somebody up there. Oh, he got me first. Right, turn out this mix up a bit. Let's go on top of here, and then what you can do is you can jump across to here. Go into here. Anybody around? Yep. bit too long a range for the... Oh, ooh, where did he come from? Double, ooh. You're going to get sticky bombed. There we go. Always a bit of fun, though not a good idea if I managed to damage myself at the same time. But sticky bombs are great to use against human players because it really annoys them. I managed to miss the entire clip into those. What's going on? Somebody there. Get him. Somebody around here. Get him. Now, I'm probably playing a little bit odd here as well because I've actually got the sound turned down on my telly, so it's not interfering with my... Although you can hear it because I'm mixing it in from the game. Let's go across here. This is always a good place. There's normally someone coming around over the top. Where's he going? Alright, he's going over there. Pull him down, spin around, shoot. Ooh, he's good. For a bot, double tap X, reload. Let's get on top of here. Quick look, keep moving, there's somebody. Ooh, he got me. That was a bit of a silly move, that. I shouldn't have been so aggressive. I'm not particularly good at shooting people in while I'm in midair. There's a couple of guys. Ooh, totally missed. A little bit far range for me. I'm not very accurate. Let's go around this side. Ooh, there you go. Get some. Somebody got me. Let's come down. All right, here we go. A couple of targets here. One behind the other. Always good. Get some. All right, here we got two guys battling out. One. Two. Right, punch. Let's get out of here. There's a grenade over the wall. What's he doing? Punch. Awesome. Reload. Let's get out of here. I'm a bit injured. Where is anybody? There you go. You can't go down there. Let's get up on top of here. Boost across. Anybody down? Let's chase this guy. Oh, I'm surprised to totally miss him loads. Somebody on my left. Missed him. Ooh, two. One. Two. Three. He's good. Ooh. See, the bots are a bit... Now, that's a classic thing where I kept sprinting and I wasn't allowing my gun to reload, so I should just take out this guy with a shield here. Where's he gone? Oh, sod it. I've missed him. Got my grenade launcher out. Let's just fire it off. Up here. Oh, he was hiding, waiting for me. Bit rubbish. Four to go. Let's see if we can do it without dying again. Famous last words. Ooh, and again. Right, concentrate, Rob. People with shotguns are very dangerous in public matches as well. They get close, you're dead, basically. And I die again. Here we go. Let's go around this way. Boost, speed up. Let's chase him. Ooh, totally miss. Come around here, there's one around here. How's he getting up there? Where'd he go? Where'd he go? There we go. Is somebody going to be around this corner? No, we're around the next one. One more kill to go and I'm doing really rubbish now. But hopefully you've got the idea of this routine. It's just all about moving fast, switching between targets, and improving your accuracy. Now, I use that with the ASM. One, but obviously you could do it with the barrel, you could do it with any weapon you're working for. I tend to prefer the ASM one, but when you're playing, for example, comeback, if people keep camping out on the roofs or in rooms, often you'll have to pull out something like the barrel. You have to switch tactics mid-game because they're not into, you know, really getting up nice and close. But don't be afraid to do that. So that's the third bit of our warm-up. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to look at doing an actual team deathmatch against bots, but the important thing is that on a map that we're not that familiar with. Okay, so the fourth part of our warm-up is going to be actually a team deathmatch instead of all these free-for-alls. So let's go into the mode, let's go into team deathmatch, and go with four friendly bots, five enemy bots. Again, change the bot difficulty if you start having trouble with dying too often and you're not getting anything out of the drill. But what you've got to do for this one, you've got to choose a map that you don't particularly like. So if there's a map that, you know, when it comes up in a public match, you're like, oh, I don't like this map, that's the map to choose. Maybe you're not that familiar with it yet. Maybe you're not sure about, you know, where the best places to go, the safe places and the tactics to use, then and choose that one. To start off with, when you're first starting doing Call of Duty Advanced Warfare Team Deathmatch, you'll probably find it's a lot of the maps. But what you'll find is you tend to... some of the maps come up more than others. But, for example, for me, a map that I struggle with an awful lot is Green Band. I don't know why, I just do. So, for me, that will be the one I'll practice with. So, go on that. Go on Green Band. And we start the game. Because I don't like this map. Sometimes I seem to have good games, and sometimes I don't. More often than not, it's I don't. Probably because it's a bit... there's lots of this ways and that's on it. And it kind of... I struggle with that. Green Band and Riot I often. So I'm going to start off with... I don't know. The Bow. And this can be part off of that, actually. Some of the maps, you're not quite sure which tactics to go for. Because, for example, this map is a real... there's long-range stuff when you get up high. And there's lots of very close-range, intense... engagements as well. So what I'll do now here is go over here, try not to fall down the gap. Go up here, hide behind a rock. Where's the enemies? All right, there's somebody over there. Oh, there he is. Let's get him. Oh, did I get him? I don't know. But kind of, you get the idea. So the idea then is to play out a full game, winning as best as you can. Ooh. Can keep. You can use your UAV or any other score streaks should you choose to add them on. And just really practice, and then if you've got to, you know, change your tactics, like get out the ASM, then start doing that. Here we go, got the ASM. Run around a bit faster, get the old overclock on. Ooh, somebody there, was there? No, it's one of my teammates. Let's go around. While we're here, actually, just doing this one. So, the essence of moving around, I've said this in other parts of the video series, is all about the crosshairs. Keeping the crosshairs in the middle of the screen where you think the next enemy is going to be. Because if the crosshairs are there, you can hip fire into that point and you might hit them. Or when you come to aim, you'll aim obviously where your crosshairs are. So as you're moving around, there we go, like this, you always keep the crosshairs where, ooh, God, that was really terrible, where you want them to go. So strafe right, strafe left. And always keep them over where the openings are. So, for example, as I'm coming up to this door, I'm trying to keep my crosshairs where the doors are. And if I've been a bit faster and would concentrate more, I'd have zapped them. So there we go. So that kind of gives you an idea of the four-step practice warm-up routine. And if you do this every time you fire up Call of Duty, before you go online, I guarantee you'll get better. You know, do the two lanes on the firing range, sort of three and four. Do the free-for-all with the BAL in Detroit. Remember, you know, put the bots to easy, and do the free-for-all with the ASM on the comeback map with the bots on normal or easy to start off with, and then do a team deathmatch again against bots on a map that you need to get better at. And in fact, if all you take from this video is these four steps and you turn it off now and start doing it, you'll get better in no time, I promise. But now what we're going to do in the rest of the video is we're going to look at some other aspects of play in a little bit more detail. Before we go any further, I just wanted to quickly just go over something that's incredibly important. That is how you set up your Xbox 360 or One or PlayStation 4 or PC. Specifically, your networking. Although our consoles and computers are great at doing wireless, you really want to be wired into your router. Because that will reduce latency. Basically, it's increasing the speed at which your connection connects to all the other consoles and players, and means you're a lot less likely to get lag. So when you fire at somebody, you know, you'll hit them, you won't get unexplained misses, people hitting you when they weren't there, and all this sort of stuff. It can really make a massive difference. And make sure you've got a really good connection with a wide connection to your router, as a bare minimum. If you go wireless, you cause all sorts of problems, and I'm pretty sure some of the best games I've ever had have been because my internet connection has been really good. The next thing you can do as well is wear headphones as well. That can make a big difference, so that you can really get the stereo effect of the game, so you can hear people approaching you from the left or the right, or even kind of almost from behind as well. What I like to do as well is play in a slightly darkened room, not really dark, you don't want to damage your eyes, but just darken it so you can really concentrate on the screen, but you don't want anything else bright in the screen distracting you. Also, when you're in a game, when you're in the lobby at the beginning, mute the other players, because there's nothing worse than trying to play a game when you've got some chatterbox waffling on or singing or playing music down there over their mic to kind of distract you. And although I haven't gone into it in detail in this video, go into the settings and look at your sensitivity and start off round about fairly low, round about 3 or 4. That's what I play with most of the time. That's sensitivity controls how fast your crosshairs whip around the screen. So keep them low, and you don't really need to go much higher than sort of 4 or 5, because that'll start to affect your accuracy over the long range, even though you'll move around faster. So there we go. But the biggest takeoff of this is make sure your Xbox or your PlayStation is hardwired into your router for the best possible internet connection you can get. So what we're going to talk about now is how to move safely around the map without getting killed too often. Well, no, I'm lying. You will get killed an awful lot, because that's what happens in team deathmatch. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to set up a local play game against some bots. We're going to be on Detroit, and I'm just going to be running around as I kind of would be, maybe a little bit slower to kind of give you some ideas of how you should be doing it. And again, one of the things I like to think of is when you first start playing, always imagine that someone's either chasing you. Okay, so you've got to keep moving, otherwise they're going to catch up and they're going to shoot you. Or there's a sniper who's aiming at you and who's trying to get a bead on you, especially when you're in open areas. So you've got to keep moving. Don't just move in straight lines. Zigzag around and get out of those open areas as fast as you can, or at least move along the edges. Because one of the things that people forget and don't realize when they first start playing COD is that your field of view is tiny. Your peripheral vision is absolutely rubbish. You know, you can't see people coming at you from the sides very well. So as you're moving around, check the corners, flick backwards and forwards, check roofs. And the big thing you'll see from doing this is, it's for me, I think anyway, is to start off with, especially, it's all about flanking. It's all about going around the edges of the map and then working your way in when you're happy to do so, or just working around the edges. Don't go straight, you know, to the middle. Anyway, here we go. Let's dive in so you can actually see what you're doing. So to start off with, you know, what do you do? Well, in this video, I'm going to do a little section about where to rush to. In this video, I'm not going to do this part of the video. I'm just going to start wandering off. And what you've got to think about is, think about the edges. So on this particular map here, just think about, we're going to move around the edges of the map. I'm not going to be going down the big middle bits. Here we go. What do we do? What happened there? I don't know what happened there. Change team. Auto assign. Here we go. Now, we're on Detroit, so I'm going to go with a BAL. So, again, if I wanted to go straight in the middle, I would head down here. But no, I don't want to do that. I want to head down here. Now, what I'm doing is, I'm moving around. Is you can see my crosshairs in the middle, right, of the screen. I'm always trying to keep my crosshairs where the doors are, where enemies would be coming from. And I'm doing that by a combination of sort of forward and back. But I'm not just going up and then turning, going forward. I'm strafing left and right. And then looking up, see how I'm trying to keep my crosshairs over that door. So that if an enemy is there, what I can do, say if I practice just going back this way. So say an enemy was to appear right now, right there. Oh, wow. And I actually shoot him rather than miss him all the time. I'm ready to fire at him. So I can either just hip fire, which is where you just start shooting without aiming. Kind of like that. Oh, there goes someone coming behind me, don't they? Let's, where are we? Let's go back over there again. Let's move over here. So as I'm going through here, I can either hip fire through the door like that, or as I say, I come around here, I can bring my sights up and fire that way. Or if he's right on top of me, I can punch. And so we're constantly doing that. We're constantly keeping our crosshairs in the middle of the screen, so that if somebody comes around the corner as we go around this car, I can aim and fire if they're a little bit further away. I can hip fire, so I can just go blah, 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 blah. Or if they're really close, I can punch. Like that, and that's very easy. Now, to take it kind of a bit of a step further as well, is obviously you're checking the mini map in the top left hand corner every now and again. If you suspect that, if you suspect an enemy's going to be there as well, you can pre-aim. So now, here's a good thing. So now it says reload in the screen. As soon as you see reload, it means you haven't got many bullets left. So don't just do a normal reload, double tap X, and that will dump out those 5 bullets and it will make you reload fast. It doesn't matter because you've only got 5 left. So as we go up here, so what pre-aiming means? So if I think there's going to be an enemy just around these lockers to the right, as I'm coming around, aim like this, aim like that, we're ready to go. If somewhere around, aim to go. This tends to be if you see somebody on the mini-map. So if I knew somebody on the mini-map was going to be there, I would pre-aim and then do it like that. In certain areas of the match, on certain maps, you'll find that not only do you pre-aim, you'll pre-fire as well. So you kind of go like this. You're coming through and you go, and you'll start firing. Because you know somebody's going to be there. So as you can see, so we're moving around. We're keeping the crosshairs where the enemy might be. Like there. And then again, I'm avoiding those wide open areas. I'm going around the edges. You saw me do a double jump there, but try and avoid double jumping. As soon as it's safe to do so, you know, reload and do a double X if you have to. Again, you know, so there's that big central area there. Ooh, let's get him. He's going around here. He's going to hop on top of here. There he is. Don't be afraid to hip fire. And we're just flanking. So again, it's really tempting to run down that big open area there. But if there was somebody up here, for example, they could be up here, they could be sniping me like this, and I wouldn't see them till it was too late. They could be over there. Let's see, someone's running up there. So again, as I come down here, this in Detroit, this is a classic, horrible place to be here. There's too many things. So again, we flank around, we're coming around to the edge, and again, we're keeping our crosshairs over the door, over where somebody could be, so we can immediately snap to shoot, or if we have to, you know, we can pre-aim as we're coming around corners. So important. Okay, so we're moving around, we're shooting the enemies, but what happens when we do decide we want to be out in the open, or we're forced to go out in the open? Now, what you want to do is when you're moving down the open bits, obviously keep moving, sprint when you can, but try and keep to the edges. Because if you keep to the edges, if there was a ledge up there for someone to fire down at you, they can't because they won't be able to see you. So try and keep to the sides, move fast. What you see me doing there is I'm doing like a boost jump. So I'm jumping a little bit and then boosting. But I'm not doing a double jump. Do a double jump and you'll appear to people will be able to see it. And then you can slide forward again. And also what you want to be doing, let's just get him out of the way. Quick reload. Is try and use cover. So it's a bit tricky because there's not much cover. So let's move over here. So as soon as we get past this ambulance, we want to get it between you and whoever's firing at me from behind. Aim, kill. Alright, we're getting low on ammo now, so I'm just going to go and nick a gun off somebody. Let's get out of range of him. Right, let's punch him. Let's get his gun. Let's come around here. Die. Right. So, as I was saying before, so using cover. So, as soon as we get past something, there's a guy there. Let's just get him first. Right, here's a good example around here. So, we can nip into here for cover. Here we go. So, cover. So, we've got lots of cover. So, we can hide behind here. Again, always check. There might be someone behind us. Reload, because it's safe. Whoa. I'm not safe. There's somebody else there. Quick reload. We're in the thick of things now. We can move up here behind the car. Pop out, shoot him. There's another one coming from the left. Get him. He got me first, wasn't on target. I was probably a little bit wounded as well. That's the thing, you know, if you're wounded, disengage, because you're probably going to die if you get hit really, really quick. And the idea is, you know, just pop out from behind cover, shoot, and if you miss him, you can pop back in behind cover. But always remember, in Advanced Warfare, things move very fast, so don't stay too long in one place, because somebody will shoot you from behind or the side like that. Now, windows. With windows, it's very tempting to run up to a window and be looking around like this and shooting people as they go past, even if they're teammates. Don't do that. Don't stay for too long. And try and do it from a little bit further back as well and crouch down. And then, you know, see if there's a shot to take. And then if there's nothing there, move on, because somebody's going to run up on you and stab you in the back or shoot you in the head. So, for example, as we come around here, look, aim, move. There's another good window just around here. So if we go in here, again, have a quick look through. There's somebody there. Oh, missed him. Again, look, and then go. Don't hang around, because somebody will see you, and they will shoot you. Again, another example would be, say, getting on top of it, like into a sniping position up here, crouch, wait, look, make your shot, ooh, if you can actually hit anybody, unlike me, and then get out of there, because they will be, as soon as you start firing, unless you've got a suppressor on your gun, they will see where you are and they will come after you, especially in a public match, because people, you know, love to get snipers. So there we go. Hopefully you've kind of seen how to safely move around the map. We're sticking to the edges of the map. We're kind of moving our crosshairs so they're always where the enemies might be coming from. You've seen me do some exo moves as well, where I'm bouncing backwards and forwards. Ooh, they're all around here now, aren't they? Ooh, let's get them with a grenade. Hopefully, no. And it's all about just kind of making progress, but not making silly dashes into the open. Pre-aiming where you have to when you go around corners, if you think people are going to be there, or it's that sort of map where the enemy seems to be on top of you. If you're into situations where you can start sniping, have a look and then keep on moving. Woo! Like so. So come back around here. And there we go. So that's how to move safely round the map. Check your corners. Don't hang around in one place too long. And imagine that somebody is always either chasing you, or if you're in an open area, there's a sniper who's trying to get a bead on you. Okay, so exo moves. Exo moves are the big difference with Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. People who have played Call of Duty for the past don't always like the advanced exo moves that we have now, but you know they're kind of a fact of life, and they are your friend. They will enable you to kind of escape and evade your opponents. So what I've done is I've just set up a quick kind of free-for-all, me versus one bot. Let's get the ASM out. Okay, so there he is straight away. So hopefully I can put some space. So you've got your basic sort of walking around, and then you push the stick forward to sort of sprint around like that as well. But we can move faster. So when you're moving forward, if you want to move really fast, you've got two choices apart from sprinting. What you can do is if you press the crouch button while sprinting forward, you'll do an exo slide like that, which is really cool. Or the other thing you do is there's that bot. If you do a little jump and then when in midair push forward, you'll do like a small exo boost jump forward like so, which is cool, isn't it? Now, if you're not moving forward, if you want to move from, there we go, let's get him, let's reload. If you want to move from side to side, you can boost left and right. So all you do is you press the left analog stick to down and to the left, and you can boost left, boost right, boost out of the way of getting killed. Here we go, where is he? So we can boost backwards, boost left. But we can't boost forward. To boost forward, you've either got to do a slide like so, or you've got to do a jump and then press forward like that. And that will get you there that way. Okay, so you'll see as I'm sort of running around the map, what I'll be doing is I do a lot of sort of sliding and then just a little jump and then push forward on the left analog stick while pressing it down to give you like a boost kick forward, because it really doesn't make a massive difference. And then when you come across an enemy, you know, engage, or if he hits you first or there's a few of them, you're not going to take them on, you know, boost backwards, boost left, boost right to get yourself out of trouble. And then we've got slide forward as well. Now, we can also jump. So we've got a normal jump, pretty pathetic, but if we press the jump button twice, we can do a boost jump into the air, which isn't always a good thing, because obviously everybody can see you jumping up, but what is good is while you're in the air, whether it be from a normal jump or a double jump, is you can boost forwards, backwards, or sideways. So as I jump, if I jump off here, ooh, there's our enemy over there, isn't he? Bit oblivious, we can boost forward like that by pressing forward and clicking down on the thing. So we can do a double jump up and then boost sideways. We can do a double jump up and boost backwards in midair. Double jump up and boost over there. So just because you're in midair, don't think you can't do, you know, make a movement. You can double up and then boost sideways to get over there. and always try and keep your crosshairs pointing where your enemy will be. Like down here. There he is. Let's catch up with him. Let's just finish him off. There we go. Quick reload. Now, the other thing you can do is while you're in air, if you press the crouch button, you'll slam down as well, like this. Ooh, let's double jump, and then slam down like that, bosh. Double jump, slam down. If you land on somebody directly, that will kill them, if you slam down. But you've got to land right on their head. But again, it's another way where if you're in midair and people are shooting at you, boost down, because that will get you back on the ground and changing direction faster than you would otherwise. Now, we can use these things to kind of double jump, get on top of buildings, double jump, and again, get there. So one of the things you could do, say you did a double jump over here, and then boost down to get down again. Now, one of the things we haven't talked about yet is mantling. Now, mantling is really important. What it means is, as you're running around, if you want to get through a window, it might seem a little bit difficult to get through windows. You know, you think, oh, I've got to jump up here. Ooh. Double jump up here, and then kind of push through. And it's all a bit slow. But you know when you go up to a window and you just press A to go through? If you keep looking at a window, and then jump up to it, you'll go through it. See that, how I went straight through that window? And that's called mantling, and it does the same for rooftops as well. So even though you might think you're gonna not want to make a jump to get to a particular rooftop, look up to where you want to go, and you'll find you'll make it. Now, there's a really good example of this over here. So if we jump across here, and then we can kind of do this really fast way of getting into that room. See that room there? So what we can do is we can be running along here, jump, boost forward, straight through there. See how fast that is? And when you see the more advanced players moving around, often they'll be doing things like this. They'll be sticking to the high ground, and they'll be boosting around, mantling, doing all these sort of little tricks to keep them off the ground and into situations where they can look down on you and then obviously have the advantage of the high ground. And again, because we can do all this jumping as well, it means that you can avoid doorways and openings. Because, you know, say if somebody wants to pre-aim, a good example is over here. If we come up here, so say someone whirls around here like this and they're aiming there because they think you're going to come through that door. Well, in advanced warfare, you don't have to use entrances like that. You can just sort of run up and boost over the top and be ready to finish him off that way. So as you can see from this kind of little guide, the exo movements really do help you. And that's why as well is having something like the overclock on so that you can speed up. Oop, let me turn it on. Turn the boost on. There we go. So now I'm so much faster moving around the map. But as you can see, the battery's running down. So I only get it for so long, but it helps you get back into the action very, very fast. And also, if you run one of the late perks that are available later on in the game, sort of fast hands, that improves the speed that XO moves happen. But always remember, the basics, even though you're zooming around doing all these XO moves, concentrate on your crosshairs in the middle of the screen so that if an enemy is there, you can just blast them with a hip fire. You can aim fast to get them. You can pre-aim as you're going around corners, just in case somebody's hiding in a corner like that. Or at last resort, you can just punch them out of existence that way. So what we're going to look at now is a little bit about the mini-map, kind of what's going on and how it can kind of tell you which way to go. Because at its most basic, the mini-map is showing you where your teammates are, and sometimes it shows where your enemies are. If someone's put a UAV up, whether yourself or any teammates. But what it doesn't show you is any enemies that are running with the low profile perk, that is. So it can be a bit of a double-edged sword. The minimap can help you because you can see that an enemy is just around the corner, but at the same time, it can be distracting. So as you look up to check it, an enemy will boost around the corner and punch you or shoot you off the map. So treat it with caution. The map will always show you your teammates and if they're firing, so you can use the logic that where your teammates are, the enemy isn't, unless of course they're firing. So when you're deciding which way to turn and go, generally be facing away from your teammates, because that means you'll be facing the direction the enemy will be coming from, so you'll be able to shoot them down if they come towards you. Because, one of the basic rules of Advanced Warfare and COD in general is that the spawn points, you know, where you kind of come back to life, won't be near where any enemies are. It'll be the other side of the map. So try glancing up at the minimap every couple of seconds, but only briefly. And as you get to know your maps, you'll get more out of the minimap. But at the beginning, just remember to move away from your teammates, flanking around the edges of the map, and that'll take you towards your enemy. So what we'll do now, we're just going to, I've just set up a little team deathmatch kind of practice on Biolab with some bots, just to kind of talk you through kind of my thinking as I'm running around, just to give you an idea. Now, because I'm talking and trying to play at the same time, this probably isn't going to go very well. So, because the good thing about Biolab is there's lots of kind of rooms to go through and lots of blind spots. So I'm going to go with the ASM because that's good for this particular map. And let's see where we're starting first. Here we go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Teammates all around me. Right, so we're going to dash up here. Put my boost on. And now, right, somebody's firing. So I reckon they're going to be in this, coming through this room. In fact, there's one there. Take him out. And there's probably one of his mates behind him. And they're probably going to be coming down this tube now. So I'm going to pre-aim, move around. Right, so my teammate is there. Looks like they're coming behind, so they might be coming from the left down there. Right, there they are. They're down there. Right, ooh, let's get round. Where's he gone? Ooh, lucky punch. Now my teammates are shooting around here, so they're probably, again, I think I need to go left, because look, there's none of my teammates in front of me. They're probably down here, maybe through to the right. There's one. There we go. Let's get him. Right, maybe there'll be another one down here. No, my teammate's there, so he's not going to be there, but perhaps maybe up here. Let's go and have a look. Up through here. Any teammates in front of me? No teammates. Enemies will be close. Let's come down here. Again, no teammates in front, so the enemies will be round here probably. Let's keep eyes peaked. Right, enemy, look at the minimap. Right, the enemies are going to be over here, through here to the left. Oh, there's one there. Right, let's grab him. Now, probably, there we go. One there. Another one there. Oh, right, let's see if we can get out and shoot this guy. Right, where's he gone? There he is. Let's get him. Right, let's crack on. Right, no teammates in front, so the enemy will probably be spawning towards this direction. Let's get ready. There's one. Let's get him. Right. Tell you what. Right. There's one of my teammates. Let's kind of take stock of the situation. So no teammates round to the left. So let's head that way. Probably where the enemy will be. Right. No. Right. Again, maybe around this way. No. So teammates. Right. That. Right. There's a red dot. Let's go and fight. Let's go and track him down. Probably through here and then round to the right on the ground. Let's go and have a look. Can't see anybody. They've probably gone up here. In fact, I can see a teammate firing up in the top left-hand corner. Right, so let's see if they've gone up here. Let's have a look round. Let's boost over to this bit. No. Okay, so right, here we go. There's one. Where there's one, there's normally another. Always be aware of that. Getting a bit low on ammo. So, someone's behind me, so let's boost. In fact, I saw him. He went that way, didn't he? He's gone through here, or is that one of my teammates? Someone's having a battle with somebody. Let's go this way. Here we go. Right, let's get him. Right, let's go nick his gun. Let's get the UAV up, so we get lots of cover. Well, what gun have we got? Bal, by the look of it. Now I'm just going to take stock of my situation. Right, so nobody in front of me. All right, I've got friendlies in front of me. Friendlies in front of me, so that means the enemy's probably going to be round to the right. There we go, there's one. Ooh, if I can actually hit somebody. Another one round to the right here. Nope, there he is. Let's get him. Right, let's go. Another one. Out of bullets, zoom, boost out of the way. Teammate trying to deal with him. Well done. Now they're gonna be coming through here. Coming through here. There they are, there's one. Let's take him down. Alright, there's gonna be more in here. Oh no, maybe they've gone to the left. There we go, there's one. Let's get him. Maybe another. Oh, I didn't get him. Yes, I did. Right, they've gone round this way. Probably gone up high. Let's see if we can get up here. Look down. There he is. There's one. Let's get him. Missed. Let's boost after him. Where'd he go? Reload. Hide. Oh, punch. No, dead. So you're kind of getting the idea then. You know, I'm looking at the mini map just briefly. and checking, you know, if there's teammates in front of me, I know the enemy's probably behind me. And if you can see your teammates firing, obviously they're engaging. So no teammates in front here, so the enemies are going to be close. They're going to be around here somewhere. There they are. There's one there. There's one up there. And there's one coming through that door, but I need to... Ooh, I'm trying to kill myself with a grenade. Quick reload. Boost over this bit. You see how powerful the minimap can be. And that's why the UAV, let's shoot that, can be very, very useful indeed. So hopefully that's given you an idea about the minimap, how useful it is. But again, don't look at it too often. You know, just glance at it because, you know, your chances are you'll look at it just as somebody pops around the corner and shoots you in the head or punches you. So what we're going to look at now is just a few example starting rushes, you know, where to go right at the beginning of a team deathmatch. Now, I'm no expert at this, you know, I'm pretty crap at rushes, but I have some favourite places to go that sometimes can lead to sort of definite kills. But the trick with most of the rushes is know exactly where you're going to go, and it tends to be somewhere where you're going to go and then crouch behind some cover. Get there very, very fast. So as soon as you start running, hit the Y button to put your gun away. And then, you know, and hit your boost if you are, and sprint to exactly where you want to be, get your gun out, crouch down, and then wait. And then only wait a couple of seconds though, because all the time you're waiting, the enemies could be coming round and flanking you from another direction. So don't just sit there waiting and waiting and waiting. As you play the games, you get to know certain rush points will lead to kills at certain times, and if the enemy isn't there by that time, go, you know, head off somewhere else, go to an alternative, start with your plan of going around the edges of the map, flanking and coming and killing him from there. But I tell you, if you do have any really good rushes that you think are very effective, make sure you put some down in the comments down below. That would be really, really good. So let's have a look at a few more starting rushes in different places.
We're in control. Taking the advantage. Weapons free. Light him up, Sentinel.
I have contact.
Let's keep this quick and clean. We're on the clock.
Okay, so there's some real common mistakes that you can try and avoid when you're playing COD, Advanced Warfare, Team Deathmatch, and I'm going to kind of highlight those by making some of them myself in a game against some bots. But trust me, I make lots of these mistakes in normal games too. So we're going to be on Detroit. It's going to be a free-for-all, even just to show you, so I get shot at lots. Against bots, they're on... just put them on regular and kind of show you. So they're kind of... These are the sort of things that you try and avoid, and you'll stay alive a little bit longer, and you'll get a few more kills for every death that you get. So I think we'll probably go with the BAL to do this match. So kind of the first sort of problem that people make when they first start doing it is a little bit of lack of map awareness, which tends to be running around in the open in the middle of the map. So I kind of show you what that means. But basically the problem with this is obviously people can see you, your enemies can see you. Let's just deal with him first. So if I'm running around, right, there we go, I got kind of get shot straight away. I was running straight out into the open. Another example would be here. You know, there's a guy down here, I can kind of get him. There's another guy there, but if I kind of hang around here, you know, I'm just going to end up kind of, oh, see, I've run out of bullets now. So I've got to reload while I'm in the moat open as well. Never a good idea. And then it's just, you tend to, well, eventually, normally you kind of get killed. See, we're getting bots here, so they're a little bit more forgiving. Another good example here is when you kind of, you fire off your gun, and you go down to a few bullets, and then you reload right in the middle of the map. What you want to do is get yourself somewhere safe, crouch down or something like that, and then do a normal reload, or do a fast reload by tapping X, and that will help an awful lot. Another real common mistake people make is they'll get themselves into what they think is a good position, say like up here on top of this bus, which isn't too bad, but they'll stay here too long. You know, maybe they'll take some pot shots off, and believe me, every time you're firing, that your enemies know where you are and they will be coming to get you. So if you get into a nice position where you can do a little bit of sniping, do a little bit of sniping, kill a few people, then move on. So, for example, over here, inside the porter cabin, you know, this is, if we sort of come back here, move back so it's a little bit safe, you know, we can do a bit of sniping here, but someone's running round. Alright, there we are, there's a guy there. But they know where we are, so I want to take a few shots and then move on before people kind of home in on where I am. There's another window over here, and I'll show you another thing. When you are going to a window to do a little bit of camping, a little bit of sniping, don't stand right next to it like this. Go back a little bit, pop up, have a look. If there's nobody there, move on, because somebody will be coming up behind you, ready to kill you pretty quick. You know, look through the hole, make your kill, and move on. Because somebody will be coming around the corner, or coming on your back and killing you that way as well. Another classic problem people make is they're kind of a little bit indecisive. You know, should I go here? Should I come out? And all the time you're staying in the same part of the map, the chances of somebody bumping into you and killing you goes up. You know, keep moving, keep flanking, keep moving around the edges of the map, checking your corners, just and get ready. And then when you see somebody, finish them off. But don't be tempted to again dash out into the middle. Keep flanking, keep moving around the edge of the map to help it that way. Now, although we do have all these beautiful exo moves in Advanced Warfare, boosting around too much is a bad idea. Although it might seem great because you can see around, all of your enemies can see you boosting around, and trust me, they will kill you. So you want to use your double jump to get up to ledges, to get up to places. You know, like here, if I want to get over here, I've got to jump up, but then crouch to slam down so you get down out of the air really fast and then get around and start killing people as well. It may seem cool to double jump, but trust me, it gets you into lots and lots of trouble because you're just hanging there and people just shoot you out of the sky. Another classic one as well is that although the BAL is a gun that's great at quite long range, especially if you're using the ASM or something like that, if someone's a long way away, don't try and take on impossible targets. If you don't think you're going to hit them, say somebody's in the distance moving a long way away and they're moving across your sights, there's very little chance you're going to hit them. But if you start firing them, unless you're using a suppressor on your gun, what will happen is everybody else will see you on the minimap and start running towards you. So if they're a long way away and you're not going to make that kill, don't fire. Wait for a better opportunity. This goes especially when you're using the ASM and any of the submachine guns, because they're great up close, but they're rubbish when you start getting a little bit further away, and you're better off just not taking that shot, moving on, and then not dying and living to fight another day. And speaking of that, the other thing you probably want to do is try and avoid revenge killing in public matches as well. So if somebody gets you from a particular place, normally a strong position, like a strong sniping position or something, don't be tempted to immediately try and go after them and kill them as well. You know, but you will get them at some point, but if you keep people who stay in the same place all the time, what they're betting on you doing is always coming back and trying to take them on from what they see as a strong position. So if you play into their hands by doing that, chances are you're going to get killed. Flank around them to the sides if you must, or lob a grenade at them or something like that, and then attack them that way. So that's always good to do it that way. And then kind of the final thing, which kind of ties in with the fact that we've got to make sure, you know, our accuracy is very good by going on the firing range and doing our drills on Detroit and on recovery with the comeback, is sort of firing around targets kind of like this. So it's when you start firing at somebody, but you're not really on target. So what you always want to do is try and get on target before you pull the trigger, so that all your bullets are going to go into them. Because especially with weapons like the BAL, which are all about rate of fire and accuracy, rather than the actual damage they're doing, because you take people down by hitting them with lots of bullets, but you've got to be on target. If you're not on target, you might as well not fired at all. There we go. Ooh, see, I missed him there. And there we go. That's some of the basic mistakes that you can make. And if you try and avoid them and don't do them like I do, then you'll live to fight a lot longer. What I wanted to talk about now was changing tactics mid-game. So sometimes you'll be playing a game and you'll have chosen your weapon, say your BAL or your ASM, based on the map. Say you're playing comeback, so you've got your ASM and you're blasting away, but it just doesn't seem to be working. The other team, maybe they're camping out in rooms on top of roofs and the ASM just hasn't got the reach to knock them down. And then what it's really important to do is not to keep plugging away because it's not working. You can either try changing your tactics and rushing them, say they're really well organized. You might have to start picking them off from a distance if they're wanting to pick out the BAL. Or another classic example, you might be playing something like Riot, where you're using the BAL to try and pick people from a distance off roofs and from corner points, but they're not playing like that. The opposition are playing down and dirty, you know, in the building and stuff like that, and they're getting the jump on you every time, and so you need to then change over to the ASM, and that's perfectly fine as well. And so you might have to flip-flop backwards and forwards between the two. Some people might say that you're better off having some really different classes, but I think, you know, having a submachine gun class and a assault rifle class really does work with the BAL and the ASM. So I've kind of set up a practice game here against some bots on Instinct to kind of show you that sort of stuff. So when we start the game, let's see where we start. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with the BAL, and I'm going to play kind of a bit of a camping game in the caves at the back. And then what I'm going to do then is I'm going to flip out the ASM and then play more of a rushing game attacking the center. Now I'm playing bots, so I don't know exactly how they're going to react. I know this kind of can work for against people, but let's have a look. Let's see what happens. So let's do my kind of regular starting rush for Instinct, which is normally kind of up here. Careful, and then I kind of jump over here, getting ready to blast anybody who comes out. Right, and then what I do is, once I'm in the caves, I like to kind of run up and down here, pre-aiming, running along, and kind of denying this area to the enemy, because I can also keep an eye out there. And then what I do is I then just basically keep running up and down, and then checking the... No, it's one of my guys. Oh, there we go. Die. And then tucking down, because in public games, people like hiding up here. They like going down there. And they're like, loads of stuff happens over there as well. And, you know, with something like the BAL, you can pick people off at a distance, especially if they're... Got zapped. Oh, we're going to make our way up there. So let's go this way this time. Right, so here we are. So I'm in the... die. One there. One there. Hopefully this area can now start to dominate it. In public death matches you can anyway. You can kind of pretty much hold this with one person. Just working backwards and forwards. Just got to watch out on people sneaking up on you. Boop. Or they've got... Come on, baby. There we go. Was there someone behind me? I think there was. There we go. You're dead too. Woo! He got me. So you kind of get the idea. Working the caves. Working backwards and forwards. And then just... But you might also suddenly think, well, actually, this isn't working for me. Maybe your team... maybe the enemy aren't coming up here. Or your team aren't doing very well, or maybe you're doing very well and you get a bit bored of it. So then what you want to do is you want to hit the start, change your loadout, go over to your machine gun, and basically the next time you die, you're going to change over. So let's get out in the open and be a bit more aggressive, so we're probably going to die quicker. Using the minimap, there's somebody down here. Ooh, there he goes. Where's he gone? He's hiding from me. Die. Right, so I'm dead. So now I'll have the ASM. So now I'm going to be a little bit more aggressive. I'm going to come straight up here. Ooh, if I can not double jump all the time. And then in a public match, this tends to be a really hot potato around here, where you can get killed straight away. I'm just going to get blown away now, aren't I? Right, good. Let's see if we can... Who can we see running around? Somebody cloaked. But not doing very well. But as you can see, now I've changed my style to more aggressive stance. Now, this isn't particularly working against these bots. I was probably better off, you know, using the BAL. Ooh, somebody over there. Ooh, there we go. Die. Let's see if we can finish a few of them off with a grenade. Ooh. We really need some cover. No, dead. See, because again, I was trying to engage somebody from a long distance with an ASM. Never a good idea. I should have been aggressive and jumped towards them. But let's try that tactic now. There we go. Let's imagine we're on. Oh, we need to get to cover. We need to reload. Where are they? Where are they? Oh, there's one. He's got his cloak on. There's another one. Let's keep moving. Oh, there's one. Oh, he got me. So there we go. In this particular match, I'm better off going back to my BAL. But if you're ever in a match where things don't seem to be going your way, whoop, there's a guy over there. See if we can flank him, come down from a different direction. Nope. Right, let's get the BAL again now. Just change your loadout. You know, go a little bit more aggressive, go a little bit more defensive. Start flanking, start taking people on directly. Where's he gone? And you can not only change your machine gun, go for it for a submachine gun, go for an assault weapon, or maybe you may even want to change your style as well. So there we go. Don't be afraid to change your loadout, change your tactics mid-game. It can often mean the difference between sort of really enjoying yourself and having a great game where you like score a few more points, and everyone will be just doing the same thing and just keep getting beaten. Okay, so what I wanted to look at in this little section of video was when to use grenades, and also how to deal with jumpers, people jumping towards you. But first off, I'm just going to go in and just play around with one of these perks, just so that you could kind of see what we're talking about. So let's go in here. Let's get rid of some of this stuff, because we don't really need some of this. But what I want is... where are we? We want to add... We might as well use Semtex. So we're going to have two Semtex. And I think we can... Ooh, if we get rid of that one. Perk 3. We can go to Bombardier. Which means we can now have a... We can have a frag grenade. There we go. I wouldn't normally run with anything like this, but I'm doing this purely so I've got three grenades to show you what you probably do with grenades. So let's come out and let's start the game. This is on green band. There'll be a bot running around, probably trying to kill me every now and again. But hopefully we can avoid him. So I just want to show you kind of the situations where you would use grenades first, and then talk a little about dealing with jumpers and people who are double jumping towards you, because it can be quite difficult, but it's also difficult to show. So there's the one. So when do you use grenades? You'll note from the beginning of the video, my setup only really includes one grenade, and it tends to be one Semtex grenade. But don't worry, you get killed often, so you get to use it quite a lot. But the Semtex grenade doesn't come until quite far on in the game. But the normal grenades are good. So when would you use a grenade? Now, one of the rules of as you're rushing around, if you're following somebody, let's move up this end of the map. Oh, there he is. Right, so let's say we were rushing around and we were chasing somebody, all right? See this door here? So we were running up, and we tried to shoot them, so we fired, and they ran through the door and went around the corner. So they did this, they went around there and went out of sight. And you're over here. Now, what they will have done, whoop, in a public deathmatch, here comes that bot again, let's finish him off. Where's he gone? Sneaky git, he's... there you go. Have some of that. What they will have done is they will have run through here as fast as they can, and they will have turned around and they'll probably be lying on the floor like that, waiting to get you as you run after them. So the first use for a grenade is when you're firing at somebody, because as soon as you fire at them, they know you're there because you've appeared on their minimap. Instead of rushing after them, you get a grenade and you lob it in after them, and then you run away. and will get shot by somebody as you're doing it. Because that means if they're sitting there waiting for you, chances are you might kill them, or it'll definitely put them off and they'll move away and then go and engage somebody else. So that's the first reason. Another reason as well is if you were in that situation yourself where you ran, there's a door there, we're running along, there's somebody, we don't know they're there, but somebody fires at us from behind, so we see some bullets whiz past us, or we see them on the minimap. As you whip round to defend the situation, you want to, if you lob a grenade and stick it somewhere like that, they will not run through that door after you, because they'll see that grenade and they'll panic, and that enables you to run away, to live to fight another day, to maybe flank them from the outside, or something like that. Another thing you can do actually as well is when you're running along, if you're coming up to a door, if you've got Semtex, fire it up above you and then run through, and that will get somebody who's following you. Another use for a grenade as well, whoop, not today my son, let's get him, is say when you're running along and you notice somebody poke their head out of a window, say they were up there, what you would do is if you couldn't get a shot at them because they keep popping back, get your grenade launcher out and then pop a grenade through and you might get them. That room's quite big in there, so you probably wouldn't get anybody in there, but especially in the smaller rooms you'll get them and they'll explode, and it'll at least put them off. Right, I'm just going to let him kill me so I can get another three grenades. Right, so we've got our three grenades. Another use for a grenade is when you're totally out of ammunition. So you're getting chased, maybe you're trying to engage with somebody, you're firing away, they keep jumping into cover, and then you're out, and then so bang, you fire a grenade off and you get out of there, because that will definitely make them jump away, and that will definitely work that way as well. Another good thing as well for grenades, say you're fighting someone who's got a shield, and they're coming towards you, get a grenade, so if you're using Semtex, fire it into the ground at their feet, and as they run over it, bang, it'll blow them up. And a real fun use for grenades as well is if you see a camper or somebody kind of just whoop, whoop, sort of, where's he gone? There he is. See somebody just kind of sitting in a corner, waiting, camping, and you can creep up on them without them seeing you. Yeah, sure, you could shoot them, you could punch them, but what's really fun if you use sticky grenades is to get a grenade and fire a grenade at them, and if you're using Semtex it sticks to them and they then explode. Now that can also be incredibly useful if you run around a corner and all of a sudden you see lots of enemies. So it could be a situation where say here he is, let him kill me. Right, so get a few more grenades. So let's say you're running along, like here, and then you come around this corner and you look, whoa, and say there's three enemies, like they're all up here. Because when you're playing Team Deathmatch online, you get come up against clans, and they'll all be working together, and you're like, Jesus, they're all coming for me. If you just pop out and start blasting, they're going to get you. So what one of the things you can do is you could, you know, have a pop, get your grenade ready, bang, fire a grenade into them. What can be a real bonus is that they'll probably scatter when they see the grenade, which is good. But if you're using a sticky grenade, if you're using Semtex, if you manage to get one of them and it sticks to them, they'll keep running with their teammates, and they might even run into each other and take each other out, which is absolutely brilliant fun that way. So as you can see, grenades are very, you know, are really, really cool things to use. But we want to avoid the problem of the paralysis of choice. So the main reasons while you use a grenade are the first ones I said. You'll be chasing somebody, you'll fire at them. Oop, in fact, let's try and get this guy with a sticky, shall we? Oh god, I got that wrong, didn't I? In fact, I managed to kill myself. Not very good. So you'll be chasing somebody, you'll fire at them, you'll miss, you won't get the kill. They know you're there. So they'll run around the corner and they'll be waiting to get you. So what you do, instead of falling for that trap, you just quickly lob a grenade through and then go somewhere else. Flank them round the other way. That's very, very useful. Or if you're in the same situation, you're running along, you notice some bullets whizzing past your head, you run through the door, you spin round, you lob a grenade at the floor, and then you run away as fast as you can, or you kill yourself with your own grenade, just like I have done there. So there we go, and you pop them through windows. You'll see people in matches, you'll probably get killed many times yourself, when what they do is they'll lob grenades, you know, right over the length of the map. trying to kill people. It may work, but it's a bit of a waste of time, to be honest, because in that time when you're looking up, chances are someone's going to come around the corner and get you. So, just to finish off this little bit of the video, let's see if I can find our little friendly bot and get him with a sticky grenade. We stuck him. Bang! And he's dead. He got us as well. So, that's grenades. Now let's talk about jumpers. Now, it's a bit difficult for me to do jumpers. What I'll try and do in this part of the video is overlay, if I can find any, pictures of me shooting jumpers. So it's somebody who, this tends to happen quite a lot on this map actually, if we come outside, keeping an eye out for that pesky little bot, there's all these sort of high points like this, where people basically will be doing this. So they'll be up here, they'll see you, they'll either shoot you, or they'll jump. And so they'll come off, imagine that dead body's me, so they'll come off, they'll do a double jump, and they'll be firing down at you as they come down. And you'll be like, ooh, panicking. The first rule is don't panic. When somebody's jumping towards you, you know, you could boost out of the way. Ooh, here's Case coming for me. And he's got me. First rule is don't panic. Remember, you can boost out of the way, you can live to fight another day. One thing you can try as well is you can jump to meet them. So if somebody jumps towards you, you can jump up. But I would say wait till you get a little bit more comfortable with your exo moves before you do that. What I recommend you do, well, the first mistake people make is that they aim and they try and follow people like this. And they're firing and trying to follow people up and down. But that doesn't work. Because, whoop, there's that bot again. Where's he gone? Which way is he going to be coming? There we go. Doesn't work. What you need to do is you kind of follow them with your gun and lead them. So you kind of go up and down, trying to get your sights in front of them. And then when you're in front of them, that's when you let them have it. Woo! Kind of a bit like that. I mean, I hit him then, or her, when she'd hit the ground. But chances are, when you're in the air, it's dead hard to hit somebody when you're coming down on them. It really is difficult. You tend to miss. So they'll probably try and hit you when they hit the ground. So, again, so as they jump, follow them, aim and lead them. And if you're unsure, boost out of the way and learn to fight another day. Often people will jump over the top of you, so you boost front and spin around. So there we go. It's really just about practice, though, and being confident to challenge people when they jump towards you. Take your time, follow, aim, lead, fire, and you'll get them. Now, when you're playing Team Deathmatch online on Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, it can be very easy to get quite tired, mentally tired, pretty quickly. And as soon as you start getting tired, you'll start making mistakes, you'll start to lose concentration, and you'll start to lose. So one thing I'd say is this is meant to be fun. So I'd say try not to play more than about 5 games in a row, unless you're really, really fresh. As I say, or otherwise, you know, you'll start to lose accuracy and you get frustrated and you get angry and definitely things won't be good. You know, so go back to shooting bots in Detroit or come back to practice. Go back on the firing range. Go and play some combat readiness. Or one of the things I like to do is if I've been playing Team Deathmatch a few times, you know, and I've, you know, I enjoy it, but it starts getting a bit intense, a bit tired, go and play a different game mode to spice things up. Go into the mosh pit, and there's loads of different ways to play Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. Obviously, you've got free-for-all, which can be really manic, but lots of fun. Domination is where things get a little bit more tactical and quite interesting as well. And in domination, what you've got to do is you've got these three flags, if you like, the A, the B, and the C. The A and the B and the C are opposite ends of the map, with normally the B in the middle. And you and your teammates have to capture them, and then capture them off the opposition. And it really is lots of fun because you've got a definite place where you need to go. You've got you've got to play the game, if you like. You have to attack the A flag and things like that, if you choose to. It can make things very, very interesting indeed. So play them. There's things like Uplink, which is like a big game of basketball. You can do that as well. Another thing that can be fun is changing your class. So, you know, I know in this video I don't go into sniping, but, you know, try one of the snipers. Take it out. Give it a go. Maybe against bots, maybe, you know, online. Try the shotguns. They can be real good fun as well. Try the light machine guns. Well, I think they're light machine guns, you know, the really heavy machine guns. and the lasers as well, they can be very good indeed. So the idea is just mix it up a bit, and if you start getting a bit tired, you're a little bit like, and your accuracy starts to go and you start to lose, no, just stop playing, go and do something else. So guarantee that practice you've put in earlier on, where you're doing your 4-point warm-up practice, where you're doing your free-for-all on Detroit, getting your accuracy and your speed up, doing your free-for-all on comeback with your ASM, getting your XO, your accuracy and your speed up, then practicing on a map you're not familiar with and doing the firing range at the beginning of all that will make you better. And the next time you come back to COD, probably the next day, you know, that muscle memory will be starting to fall into place and you become a much better player. Okay, we're very, very lucky with COD AW Team Deathmatch. When you want to get better, there's this amazing thing called YouTube, and there's also Twitch as well. And Twitch is like the live version of YouTube, if you like. If you want to watch live players playing stuff, then you can go over there. And if you want to see like the archive of stuff, people tend to put it on YouTube, but they also put lots of guides. All you need to do is go to YouTube and type in something like Call of Duty or COD AW multiplayer gameplay tips, and there are hundreds and hundreds of different videos that you can watch people doing what they're doing. Take everything with a hefty pinch of salt, because often these guys are incredible players already, and they kind of, it seems very simple when they show it, and then when you actually get into a public match, things will be very difficult. But you can only take a few good points from every video, even if just to see how other people play, the tactics they use, how they nip in and about, how they don't tend to dash around blindly, but you know, have tactics for what they're doing. A couple of YouTubers who are really good that you should check out are Driftor. He does some amazingly in-depth stuff on different weapons and gameplay and the maps, and the Exclusive Ace as well. He's really good. Specifically with him, if you go to his playlists and he does the breakdown where he looks at gameplay from different players and sort of points out the things that they could get better, and also he does his Maps Exposed series where he looks at maps and shows you lots of different lines of sight, mainly for things like domination, but you know, the little hints and tips really come into really help with Team Deathmatch as well. So as I say, look at the Exclusive Ace, look at Drifter, just do YouTube searches, dip in and out, subscribe to the players that you like, that kind of match your style, and you like what they're saying, and you can get better in no time at all. However, when you're starting out, no matter how hard you practice, you'll often just end up getting your butt kicked again and again, because the learning curve can be pretty steep to start off with. But fear not, Call of Duty Advanced Warfare have thought of this with the Combat Readiness Program, where you'll be anonymously pitched into battle against similar players and bots, and you'll be awarded score streaks every now and again for free, so you can get used to the different ones. But it's all about playing against some humans and some bots without the humiliation you get of the public matches. Now, I played Combat Readiness quite a lot to start off with. It's a big confidence booster, but there are a couple of catches. You can't pick out the exact weapon and loadout you use in the real public matches, and sometimes you've got to wait a while to get a match, because not everybody knows about it and not everybody uses about it. And obviously the points that you get here don't go towards any of your other stuff. But other than that, I'd say give it a crack and get the taste for winning. Because I know right at the beginning, just getting beaten again and again and again can be really it puts you off the game, to be quite honest, where you can dip into the Combat Readiness Program. You're forced to use different weapons that you would normally use, so sometimes you might come across other stuff. You can get perks and add-ons and attachments that you wouldn't normally get in until you class up, and you know, it can be great fun. As I said, it's totally anonymous. Like here, I don't know, let's have a look. We're on Riot. I've got the SM, I've got a couple of threat grenades, I think I've got some interesting, I've got here we go, it looks like I've got Gung Ho as a variant, right, here we go. Oh, I've got red dot sight. Let's see what we can do. Obviously, if you're an experienced player, then coming down into this bit isn't always fair, I don't think. But it's a lot easier than playing some of the public matches. As I say, some of these enemies are bots, some of them are real people, but it's all anonymous. So there's no worrying. Ooh, totally missed him. But there we go, the combat readiness program. If you're not quite sure, give it a go. So there we go, we've come almost to the end of the video. And if you're still here, congratulations, and I thank you very much. I mean, Call of Duty Advanced Warfare Team Deathmatch is, I think, an absolutely amazing experience. It's highly immersive, it's high adrenaline. It's a joyride that is a really great gaming experience. But it can get really frustrating when you start out because you just get killed so many times. But, you know, if you follow some, at least some of the advice in this video, and especially the 4-step practice warm-up, I guarantee within a month or so you'll be the highest scorer on a winning team. It won't happen often. In fact, you know, it might be once in a blue moon, but it will happen. Get on that firing range, do two. Get down to Detroit on a free-for-all against easy bots, recruit bots, with your bow to get up your accuracy. Get yourself onto comeback with the ASM, with harder bots jumping around again, free-for-all, just improving your exo skills as well, and then do a team deathmatch against, you know, easy bots to start off with, and then normal bots to get used to a particular map, and then dive in to the public matches. And remember that the base of all of this success is your accuracy with your gun, you know. Although there are all these other score streaks to have, and you watch the guys on YouTube and they're bringing in bombing runs and paladins and all sorts of things, remember, you running around with your gun will normally, in that same period of time, get you more kills than if you brought in something special. So don't get distracted by adding unnecessary score streaks to your loadout at the expense of perks or attachments that would, you know, that increase your effectiveness as a killing machine with machine gun. Keep it simple. So again, you're avoiding this idea of paralysis of decision. You know, in any given situation, you see an enemy, you're either going to shoot him with your grenade, shoot him with your machine gun, you're going to punch him, or you're going to run away. You know, nothing else. And I guess, you know, kind of finally, how do you know when you're getting better? And I'd say, you know, it can be quite gradual. Then all of a sudden, you might suddenly see a big jump in it. But what you're looking for is when your kills outnumber your deaths. You know, and at first, this won't happen very often because, again, the whole point with Advanced Warfare is you've got to get killed a lot in order to kill a lot. You know, look at the guys who are winning the games, the high scorers. They might have 35 kills, but they've probably died 25 times, you know, to get that. But if you stick with the drills and keep practicing, it will happen. And remember, if you're in a game where you get killed 10 times, but you kill 15 times, that's a +5, isn't it? You know, that's just as good a performance for your team as somebody who got 30 kills but got killed 25 times. You know, but stay at it. And, you know, even if you do get killed lots, you know, you only get like 5 kills but you get killed 15 times, don't worry. Go again. Because eventually you'll just start to instinctively react, and you'll start to get double or triple kills, or you're now to boost out of situations, and it will start to feel really good. That muscle memory will build up. So before we have a look at some example gameplay, I'd like to leave you with a final thought. Remember, this is all meant to be fun. So if you approach every game with a positive attitude and treat every defeat and misfortune as a learning experience, you'll get so much more out of the game. As I said right at the beginning of the video, I'm no expert. I'm a beginner myself, and I think that's why I wanted to do this video, because a lot of this stuff is fresh in my mind. But if you've got any great tips or hints for beginners, or links to great videos or articles, or, you know, if you've had some success with this guide, or, you know, there's things wrong with it and you want to say, please leave them in the comments below. It would really be much appreciated. You can email me, scalespeed@gmail.com. All I remain to say is thanks for watching. Have a look at me in action, and let's see if I can back up what I've been saying. My name's Rob, and hopefully I'll see you again soon.
All right, Atlas. Let's keep this quick and clean. We're on the clock. have the lead. We've lost control. Taken the lead. Advantage. Enemy recon drone detected. Standing by. UAV is online. Enemy UAV above. Incoming enemy care package.
Ah.
we've lost the advantage. Taken the advantage. Enemy care package incoming. Friendly UAV above. Enemy missile strikes. We've taken the lead. We've lost the advantage. We're losing. Our UAV is online. Enemy UAV above. We have the lead. Friendly UAV above. Well fought, gents. I knew we hired you for a reason.